The spread of the new coronavirus has made the fear of death a reality, causing panic in many parts of the world. Empty supermarket shelves and out-of-stock toilet paper. People's anxiety and impatience are always in a state of full charge.
新型コロナウイルスの蔓延で死の恐怖が現実のものとなり、世界各地でパニックが起きています。スーパーの棚が空っぽになり、トイレットペーパーの在庫切れ。人の不安や焦りは常にフル充電状態。
At times like these, it might be a good idea to listen to the words of German Chancellor Angela Merkel, who is no longer frustrated or aggressive, and who has also won strong public support for her new corona measures.
そんな時は、もはやイライラも攻撃性もなく、新たなコロナ対策でも国民の強い支持を得ているドイツのアンゲラ・メルケル首相の言葉に耳を傾けてみるのもいいかもしれません。
I was privileged to be selected as one of the top five Merkel's memoirs of the Corona crisis to introduce Merkel's path and achievements behind the memoirs, and to explore how we can foster a strong and flexible mind.
メルケル首相のコロナ危機回顧録トップ5に選ばれたことを光栄に思い、回顧録の裏にあるメルケル首相の軌跡や功績を紹介しながら、強く柔軟な心を育む方法を探ります。
Number 5. We don't talk about anyone, we talk to them directly.
第5回、誰かの話ではなく、直接話をする。
Chancellor Merkel said ahead of her first US-German summit with US President Trump in March 2017. At the time, Mr. Trump felt that Chancellor Merkel's policy of accepting refugees was a tragedy and that he would impose high tariffs on German cars, putting strong pressure on Germany.The leader of the European Union, to make concessions in trade negotiations. After the meeting, however, Mr. Trump took a turn for the worse and even gave lip service to Ms. Merkel, saying that she was a great leader.
メルケル首相は2017年3月、トランプ米大統領との初の米独首脳会談を前にこう語った。当時、トランプ氏はメルケル首相の難民受け入れ政策は悲劇だとし、ドイツ社に高額関税を課すことを誓い、
This phrase, you'll know it when you talk to me, is also typical of Merkel's style, an expression she has used every time she confronted Russian President Vladimir Putin or Turkish President Erdogan. He is confident that no matter how scary he is, if he goes out there, he can find his place.
この話せばわかるという言葉も、ロシアのプーチン大統領やトルコのエルドアン大統領と対峙するたびに使ってきたメルケルさんらしい表現だ。どんなに怖くても、外に出れば自分の居場所を見つけられると自信を持っている。
This confidence is underpinned by a solid track record of achievement, including the peace agreement on the conflict in Ukraine, 2002, which Mr. Putin and I worked out in all-night negotiations, and the refugee agreement with Erdogan and the EU, 2004, which stopped the flow of refugees into the EU. The following words illustrate what is at the heart of Merkel's way of negotiating.
その自信は、プーチン氏と徹夜で交渉したウクライナ紛争和平合意2002年や EU への難民流入を阻止したエルドアン大統領との難民合意2004年など確かな実績に裏打ちされている。メルケルの交渉術の根幹にあるものを次の言葉で説明しています。
Number 4. If the benefits outweigh the detriments, compromise is the best solution.
その4、メリットがデメリットを上回るのであれば、妥協が最善の解決策である。
Since becoming Chancellor in 2005, Merkel has been nicknamed Mama by the public for her ability to handle difficult diplomatic and domestic issues with an outstanding sense of stability and negotiating skills. The fact that he was able to speak his mind and remember his humor in a relaxed manner must have given him the impression of a dependable German mother of balls.
メルケル氏は2005年に首相に就任して以来、外交や国内の難しい問題を抜群の安定感と交渉力で処理する能力で、国民からママの異名を取っている。自分の意見を堂々と発言し、 ユーモアを忘れないところが頼りになるドイツのタマの母という印象を与えたのでしょう。
On the other hand, there are many mysteries about Merkel's personality and way of thinking, which are the source of her political judgment and her experiences in her personal life, which she rarely talks about. A number of Merkel books have been published in Germany, including Merkel's dictionary, All About the Chancellor, 16, in an attempt to uncover the mystery of her words. The dictionary describes compromise as a central concept in Merkel's political thought.
その一方で、メルケルの政治判断の源となる性格や考え方については謎が多く、私生活ではほとんど語られていない体験談もあります。ドイツではメルケルの辞典をはじめ、メルケルに関する本が数多く出版されています。彼女の言葉の謎を解き明かす。
The words, which rang forth, came in an interview with the German newspaper Zeit in 13.This attitude of finding a compromise that allows the other side to have a certain amount of flowers has been seen, among other things, in the confrontation with conservatives in the ruling party over refugee policy and support for Greece.
4位にランクインしたこの言葉は、13年にドイツの新聞、サイトのインタビューで語られたものだ。相手にある程度の花を持たせる妥協点を見つけようとする姿勢は、難民政策やギリシャ支援をめぐる与党内の保守派との対立などで見られてきた。
However, since the arrival of the Trump administration, the limitations of this approach have been exposed. This is because of the rise of Mr. Trump and other macho politicians who will not allow any objections or counter-arguments. So Merkel has devised a way of clearly stating differences of opinion.
しかし、トランプ政権になってからはこの手法の限界が露呈してきた。トランプ氏をはじめとするマッチョな政治家が台頭してきたことで、反論や反論を一切許さなくなってきたからだ。そこでメルケルは意見の違いを明確に示す方法を考案した。
At the 2005 Grams 20 summit in Hamburg, the confrontation between Mr. Trump, who announced his withdrawal from the Paris Agreement, a framework for combating global warming, and Japan, Europe, and other nations calling for the agreement to be promoted, intensified. While Merkel included language saying that she would take note of the U.S. decision to leave the Paris Agreement, she also compiled a bipartisan summit declaration stating that non-U.S. members agreed that the Paris Agreement was irreversible.
2005年のハンブルグでの G20 サミットでは、地球温暖化対策の枠組み、パリ協定からの離脱を表明したトランプ氏と、協定の推進を求める日欧などの対立が激化した。メルケル氏は、米国のパリ協定離脱決定に留意するとの。
The word compromise is a word that helps to lighten the burden of the heart, but unfortunately it has become harder to use in this age of strength and clarity, and this is what the G20 was forced to do. In recent years, Merkel herself seems to have refrained from using phrases that lack strength, such as compromise, or because there is no other option. Although, as usual, he does not explain this change in detail.
妥協という言葉は心の重荷を軽くしてくれる言葉だが、強さと明快さが求められる現代では残念ながら使いづらくなっており、 G20 ではそれを余儀なくされた。メルケル自身も近年は妥協や他に選択肢がないからなど強さに欠けるフレーズを使うことを控えているようだ。とはいえ、
Why is Merkel so reluctant to talk about her own ideas to support her policies?The history of Germany as a divided nation has had an impact on this.
メルケルはなぜ自分の政策を裏付けるために自分の考えを語ることに消極的なのだろうか。ドイツが分断国家であった歴史が影響しているのだろう。
Number 3 in my life, silence was often the best way to go.
その3、私の人生では沈黙が最善の道であることが多かった。
Born in Hamburg in northern West Germany in 1954, Chancellor Merkel moved to East Germany soon after she was born due to the work of her father, a pastor, and grew up in the small northeastern town of Templin, she said in an interview with German media in 2007. East Germany, where the Ministry of State Security, known as the Stasi, established one of the largest surveillance states in the world. Mr. Merkel spent this period consistently as a researcher in physical chemistry.
1954年に西ドイツ北部のハンブルクで生まれたメルケル首相は、牧師であった父の仕事の関係で生後間もなく東ドイツに移り住み、北東部の小さな町テンプリンで育ったと2007年にドイツメディアのインタビューで語っている。シュタージと
The distrust of the dictatorship, I chose natural science because there is no room for the East German government to get involved. Merkel's official website has probably led her to develop the self-defense of silence.
東ドイツ政府が関与する余地がないから自然科学を選んだ。メルケル氏の公式サイトという独裁者への不信感が彼女を沈黙の自己防衛に向かわせたのだろう。
Mainly, people lie when they are pandering to others or trying to protect their own interests and pride. But at times like these, Merkel tries to avoid lying and remain silent.
主に人は他人に迎合したり自分の利益やプライドを守ろうとするときに嘘をつく。しかしこういうときにはメルケルは嘘をつかないようにして沈黙を貫こうとする。
As usual, Merkel has never explained why, but she probably thinks that the most dangerous thing in politics is to lie about expediency in order to gain temporary support or profit.
いつものようにメルケルはその理由を説明していないが、おそらく彼女は一時的な支持や利益を得るために都合のいいように嘘をつくことが政治で最も危険だと考えているのだろう。
In the European refugee crisis of 15, the verb to Merkel was listed as a candidate for Youth Word of the Year. It means silence without explaining it with your own mouth. The current corona crisis was also criticized for its long silence until early March, when the government announced its measures.
15年の欧州難民問題では
To Merkel
という動詞が今年の若者言葉の候補に上がっていた。意味は自分の口で説明せずに黙っていること。今回のコロナ危機も政府が対策を発表する3月上旬まで沈黙が長かったと批判された。
But compared to Mr. Trump, who lies about the spread of the new coronavirusSaying that he is completely in control of the spread of the virus, and then immediately tries to counter any inconvenient facts with fake news after the situation worsens, Merkel's refusal to say anything superfluous except objective facts appears to be an effective way of dealing with anxiety.
しかし、新型コロナウイルスの拡散について完全にコントロールしていると嘘をつき、事態が悪化してからすぐに都合の悪い事実をフェイクニュースで反論しようとするトランプ氏に比べれば、客観的な事実以外の余計なことを言わないメルケル氏の発言拒否は不安への対処法として有効なように見える。
It looks like the Buddha speak the truth. It's as if he's practicing the teachings of Don't be angry, Buddha's words of truth, words of Kenko, Iwanami Bunko. Now that everyone is anxious, maybe the effectiveness of silence will be re-evaluated.
まるでお釈迦様の真実を語れ、怒るなという教えを実践しているようにも見える。ブッダの真実の言葉観光の言葉岩波文庫。みんなが不安になっている今、沈黙の効果が再評価されるのかもしれません。
Number 2, experts expect up to 60-70% of the population to be infected with the new coronavirus.
その2、専門家は最大で 60-70% の人が新型コロナウイルスに感染すると予想している。
At the beginning of a March 11th press conference explaining the government's first new corona measures, Merkel made these remarks and made it clear that the entire European region was in danger. The sense of crisis spread rapidly among Germans, who had been optimistic that it was just a common cold.And the spread of hand washing habits and refraining from going out of the house began to spread throughout the country.
メルケル首相は3月11日、政府初の新型コロナ対策を説明する記者会見の冒頭でこのような発言をし、欧州全域が危機に瀕していることを明らかにした。単なる風邪だと楽観視していたドイツ人の間で危機感が急速に広がり、 手洗いの習慣や外出を控えることが全国に広がり始めた。
Instead of hiding or trivializing inconvenient figures to ease anxiety, one of Merkel's crisis management techniques is to make the data clear from the start, not shroud it. The government does not have to change its projections until more than 58 million people, or 70% of the population, have been infected, and the effect is that the government is not forced to change its projections again and again at a later date, increasing the public's distrust of being duped.
不都合な数字を隠したり、矮小化して不安を和らげるのではなく、データを包み隠さず最初から明らかにするのがメルケルの危機管理術の一つである。人口の7割にあたる5800万人以上が感染するまでは政府の予測を変更する必要がなく、後日何度も予測を変更さ。
John Maynard Keynes, the British economist who was called the father of macroeconomics, called for a responsibility to recommend effective policies, saying that if an economist casually says in times of crisis, when the storm passes, the sea will be calm again, he will undermine the value of his work.
マクロ経済学の父と呼ばれた英国の経済学者ジョン・メイナード・ケインズは、経済学者が危機の時に嵐が過ぎれば海は再び穏やかになるとさりげなく言ってしまうと、その仕事の価値を損なうことになるとして、効果的な政策を提言する責任を求めた。
In response to the new corona crisis, the German government was quick to come up with measures worth 156 billion euros, about 18.72 trillion yen, including income guarantee subsidies and loans for companies and sole proprietors. In telling the public the facts that hurt their ears and seeking to buy time to slow the spread of the infection, Merkel also created an environment in which the public could refrain from going out with a certain degree of reassurance. In the latest poll,About 72% of the respondents said they appreciated Merkel's response.
新たなコロナ危機を受けて、ドイツ政府は早速、所得保障補助金や企業・個人事業主への融資など、1560億ユーロ、約18兆7200億円相当の対策を打ち出した。メルケル首
相。No one, where there is a will, there is a way.
第1位、意思があるところには道がある。
These were the words that Ms. Merkel often used when faced with historic difficulties, such as the Greek debt crisis of 15 years and the negotiation of Britain's exit from the European Union.
15年のギリシャ債務危機や英国の欧州連合 EU 離脱交渉など、歴史的困難に直面した際にメルケルさんがよく口にした言葉です。
With the unstoppable rise in the number of new coronavirus infections and deaths,And with the worst economic crisis of the century on the horizon, no one can be immune to anxiety and panic.
コロナウイルスの新規感染者数の増加と死亡者数の増加が止まらず、今世紀最悪の経済危機が地平線上にある今、誰もが不安とパニックから逃れることはできません。
Great panic is created when individuals become a little selfish and lose their mental space from a vague anxiety about the future of.What will happen tomorrow to buying toilet paper even though they don't need it, etc. Looking back at history, politicians who appealed to simple and violent solutions in such times have seized power and caused a tragedy rarely seen in human history.
明日はどうなるのだろうという漠然とした不安から、必要ないのにトイレットペーパーを買ってしまうなど、個人が少しわがままになって精神的なゆとりを失った時に、大きなパニックが生まれるのです。歴史を振り返ってみると、このような時代に単純で暴力的な解決策を訴えた政治家が権力を掌握し、人類史上まれに見る悲劇を引き起こし。
Now is the time to rephrase Merkel's words in your own way. We don't buy toilet paper because we have the will to help those who are really in need, and we don't buy toilet paper because we have the strong will of people all over the world, so we will surely find a cure and a vaccine.
今こそメルケルの言葉を自分なりに言い換えてみましょう。本当に困っている人を助けようという意思があるからトイレットペーパーを買わないし、世界中の人々の強い意思があるからトイレットペーパーを買わない。だから必ず治療法やワクチンが見つかる。
She may not be able to look as carefree as Merkel, but she can certainly feel positive, if only faintly. It gives me hope that people from around the world who have never met each other are joining forces to defeat the new corona. There, the path to the exit of the crisis opens.
メルケルのようにのんきには見えないかもしれないが、彼女はかすかにでも前向きな気持ちになれることは確かだ。それは面識のない世界中の人々が力を合わせて新しいコロナを倒すために力を合わせていることに希望を与えてくれる。そこに危機の出口への道が開ける。